here we go.
Hello everyone, welcome along to the Clipsal Powerhouse for Ten's World of Sports coverage of the State League Basketball Championships. Today's game is the grand final in the men's division. It's between the West Adelaide Bearcats and also the Noarlunga City Tigers. Joining me in commentary is former 36 superstar Darryl Pearce.
And the starting fives for both teams for Noarlunga City Tigers, Travis Lever, Darren Carroll, Ricky Simpson, Rick Hodges in the centre and Eric Razgacek. For the Bearcats, Brad McKinnon and Matt Hughes in the backcourt, Paul Bell at forward, Marcel Hoogkoop and Big Willie Simmons in the post.
Here's the benches for both sides, for the Tigers and the Bearcats. So, Piercy, who's your tip?
I think West, after finishing fourth at the end of the minor round, a good win over my team, the Forrestal Eagles, and that was a great lead into the game last week against Sturt. They've knocked Sturt off, and even though Tigers have gone through to automatically go into this final, I think West are on the roll.
Last time these two sides met, there was an all-in brawl.
Yeah, pretty controversial, so there's a little bit of spite in that last game, and I'm sure today we played in a fair way, but a little bit of feeling out there, and I think the definite turning point here will be Willie Simmons' effect on the game. He's been leading from the front for the Bearcats. If he scores heavily, they win.
Gee, and Rick Hodges, 43 years of age. So we're all set to go now. This is the Men's State League Basketball Grand Final, and we are away. West Adelaide Bearcats in the red, and Noarlunga City Tigers in the black and gold. They've got a chance here, West Adelaide. This is Hughes. Nothing doing for him, though.
Hughes has been in superb form this season and really has led the Bearcats into the finals, and a heavy scorer for them so far, and they've relied heavily on his point production as we see the Bearcats opening in the zone, testing out Noarlunga from the outside. They're probably not renowned for their outside shooting, but Razgacek can score. Comes up short on that. Good hustle from Darren Carroll, though, gets the ball back, and a new shot clock for Noarlunga.
Early stages of the final. This is the grand final. Good crowd too. And at the Clipsal Powerhouse, here's Ricky Simpson, and Simpson gets a three-pointer. Great start for the Noarlunga side.
Ricky Simpson, veteran of NBL and the Bank SA League, and you can't leave him alone on the outside. As Simmons posts up, jump hook no good, and Razgacek with his second rebound from two defences gets it into Travis Lever's hands. Ex-Sturt player, Travis Lever's been at Noarlunga for a while now, and he's their dogged defender.
He had a great season.
Yes, he's a real blue-collar worker. Hodges inside to the feet. That'll be score. And probably just trying to up-fake Willie Simmons and move him and shuffle the feet. And Rick Hodges at 43 years of age and looks in better shape now than when he played for Australia at the World Championship. So,
do you think he'll ever make 43? Three sip. And West Adelaide into attack now. Willie Simmons, who obviously is a key for them. Bradley McKinnon, we've seen him many times for the Sixers, of course, and a good start for him for a two-pointer. It's 3-2, Noarlunga lead by one.
Good penetration by McKinnon, just going right down the seam there, and the double pump layup. You'd expect McKinnon to be dominant in this game, given that he's an NBL player, but of course he's going to have the best defender on him, so let's rely heavily on their guard, the Fuse and McKinnon. Darren Carroll being allowed to drive middle, bad into the defence there, and Banks too.
Here's McKinnon now again, once again in the action. Little hook, but nothing doing there. And Hodges gets it away. This is Lever. All the way goes Lever, but can't score. 5-2. Noarlunga in front, and the margin is 3.
And Travis Lever just trying to draw the foul there, no call. And on his follow-through, missing the shot and pushing off and getting the what would have been an offensive foul, I suppose. Sorry, loose ball foul, their first defensive foul. So West now with the high-low, looking for Willie Simmons in the post. Mark that down as two. Just too tall, Willie Simmons. Just sealing his man in the low block there, and good high-low play from West.
5-4, won the difference. So Noarlunga in front. Darren Carroll, who is a policeman.
Yes, a fairly feisty sort of player, Darren Carroll. Gets right into it and throws his body around like there's no tomorrow.
Razgacek. Still with Razgacek for a couple. Off target. McKinnon.
quickly down into a scoring region. Look away pass, and here's three. Oh, that's a good piece of work there by Hishkoop. It was two, in fact. It's 5-6, and West Adelaide in front.
Probably just out of his normal range there, and the defence just not respecting that. He made no mistake and opens his scoring. West just sitting in this zone. There's no use passing the ball around the outside. You've got to penetrate like that. And Aaron Carroll intimidated there. Rick Hodges with the scraps, and Raskacek puts a lid on it. Cut the basket to Hodges there. Good penetration from Carroll. He drew Willie Simmons into a help situation and left the offensive rebound in place. Simmons going to work in the low block on Hodges. There's an athletic advantage there, obviously. Rick's got to play good body work there. And I think the way to play Willie is turn him right. And he can't stop that left-hand jump hook.
7-8. West Adelaide in front. Three-point attempt there. Off target, Bell gets it away quickly to McKinnon. Nice bounce pass, chance again for West Adelaide. Almost tipped in there, but by Hishkoop, I think that was. And Paul Bell involved in all of that. It's still 8-7, and we've got a tick under 8 minutes to go until the first break.
Good rebound there from Darren Carroll, and came up with the scraps there. He's in everything, and a very inspirational player for his team. Again, no longer just running out of options here. Travis Lever organising the troops. Probably out of Carroll's range. He'll look to penetrate. Just banks the soft banker there off the window.
A bit of pushing and shoving, the two sevens.
Yeah, well, I didn't see the fight when these two teams had a go, but I would imagine the two players, two number sevens, would have been involved in there somewhere. I think Matt Hughes was reported in that incident and got off on a technicality, so fortunately he was allowed to play in the final series. Four shot from Paul Bell there. No longer on the rebound, and that's a foul that had to happen. Darren Carroll just cutting in front of Matt Hughes there. And just taking his running there, forcing the contact. Matt Hughes caught out of position. It had to be a foul. And we acknowledge that.
How do you rate the start of the game so far, producer?
Well, it's just a cat and mouse game at the moment. Probably there would be a little bit more aggression and vigour in the game if West had started in a man-to-man. But they're in a zone, and I suppose they're just collapsing a little bit, trying to nullify the inside strength of Raskacek and Rick Hodges. And I suppose tempting Nolunga to shoot from the outside, with Simpson the only recognised three-point shooter. And as we see, Darren Carroll not getting that, and the scraps go to West Adelaide. Hughes gets the ball into play to McKinnon, who's looking to score and drive.
Crash, bang. Hughes now three-point territory. Off target that time. Nolunga, a chance. Nice pass off. It was a terrific little pass off there by Lever.
Here's Travis Lever here, drawing Matt Hughes. Faked the shot, Hughes turned his back and then found the dish. Darren Carroll again, just leaning in and making sure his defensive player had to foul him. And Matt Hughes picks up a similar foul, so he's on two fouls. Darren Carroll only one of two last time at the stripe. And luck of the Irish there. Interesting to see if West stay in the zone, because normally good teams find counters to defensive changes, and I think the answer is not to blaze from the three-point line. No longer need to penetrate and draw the back of the zone out, dish off to their big players underneath. So see Willie Simmons banging with Rick Hodges. He won't shoot from there. McKinnon looking hungry to score. Three-point attempt, no good. And Travis Lever just getting the timing right there. For Travis Lever spotting up, I think. It's Carroll to Raskacek, looking for the high loader to Hodges. 10-second buzzer. And an errant pass there. West on the break, and that's Travis Lever's foul.
Feeling there's no love lost here between these two sides, so certainly from this season.
Yeah, I think it doesn't matter what level you're playing at, this is the big deal for everyone in this competition, and you get very few chances at winning a grand final in any grade, so the stakes are high. It's McKinnon with a step back, and Travis Lever getting right up into Marcel Hishkoop's dish, and he didn't like it one bit. And he's called for hooking, and Travis does have the ability to make it look very good.
David Spear already on for West Adelaide.
Yeah, David in a coaching playing role, which is pretty hard, and he'd rely heavily on his assistant coach, Phil Smythe, on the bench.
12-8. And Norlunga in front. West Adelaide, turnover. Here's Bradley McKinnon. And it doesn't come off for him. And Ricky Simpson comes away with it. Gee, that's a terrific pass. Marvellous work, and Lever scores the two, but put that down to Ricky Simpson. Marvellous work.
Look at Simpson. This has to be on the money to be successful. A log pass over two defenders and just over the outstretched hand of Marcel Heitschkoop. Lever made no mistake. And it's a clever pass. It's an 80-foot pass. Adam Cunningham into the game for West. So David Spear not afraid to sub pretty freely early.
Well, he's made some changes. Gee, it's only early stages, Dal.
Well, we've got a fair bit of depth, West, and Cunningham played very well in their semi-final win over Forestville. Couldn't come up with the points there, but knocked down a couple of very important threes in that game. So he showed me some outside game I didn't know he had.
Simpson, who was involved in a marvellous piece of work a minute or so ago. Here he is again. Oh, don't tell me. That was fantastic. Ricky Simpson, take a bow. Brilliant work by number four for the Norlunga City Tigers.
Well, Simpson's making all the play at the moment. He's the inspiration for Norlunga. And Heitschkoop taking it hard. And Darren Carroll just losing his footing there and accidentally fouling. Heitschkoop will go to the line. Here's the replay here. Heitschkoop colliding there with Darren Carroll. Nothing much he could have done about that. And his first foul, and Heitschkoop to the line.
16-8, good start for Norlunga.
Yeah, they're playing with a lot of emotion and a lot of hype. Of course, they're women's ball, and they've got a good crowd behind them. Norlunga have always had a good following. I said earlier during the season that I thought on form Norlunga were the team to beat a long time ago because they spanked us early in the season. But they've been a little bit hot and cold for their sake. Let's hope that they put it all together for their coach, Mike Osborne, there on screen. Bay 36's original coach, you know, 82, 3 and 4. And my first NBL coach. Bit of soft spot for Mike, played a big part in my career.
Well, I spoke to Mike a couple of nights ago. I must thank him for all the information he gave me. He was most helpful. And speaking about the most helpful, Willie Simmons was very helpful there in getting West Adelaide into their attacking zone. David Spear, the coach.
Norlunga playing without Ben Osborne, who's normally their starting point guard. He's playing college basketball in the States. Mick Osborne's son, of course. Big hole to fill as Willie Simmons shuffles the feet and travels. Turn over to the Bearcats. And Billy Hopkins comes into the game for the first time early for Norlunga. And Dan Van Hulst-Pelican, which is a mouthful, comes to the game, and he's got the job in Eric Razgacek.
It'll be interesting.
Well, West changing it up now with a few subs coming in. They're into a man-to-man.
16-8. Three and three-quarter minutes to go until three-quarter time. Lever. Three. Big one for Travis Lever, the 23-year-old. 19-8.
Interesting to see the reaction there on that big three from Rick Hodges. He's excited, and he plays with the same passion now as he did when he was 23 years of age. So Hodges was excited with Lever getting that three-pointer. Razgacek cleans up the boards yet again for his third or fourth rebound already. Billy Hopkins setting things up with the Tigers.
Seen a lot of him?
No, he probably doesn't play a lot, but both coaches not afraid to throw in their young boys and mix it up a little bit as Hodges looks to operate. Left-hand hook shot. Just missing that, and important that he goes at Willie Simmons. He tries to get him into foul trouble.
He's handy, isn't he, Simmons? I know that's an understatement, but
well, he legitimately plays above the ring, and very few in this competition do. And that just made him so hard to... And that's exactly what we're talking about.
Yes, we're on cue. Have a look at that. Just fantastic work. But to Norlunga's credit, oh, geez, getting himself into a bit of trouble there, Rick Hodges, the veteran. Have a look at Ricky Simpson, though. Nice pass out to Hopkins, still with Hopkins.
And McKinnon with a foul there. A lot of ball in that, but let's just have a look. He's called for a body foul, up fake, and called for the push. So Hopkins to the line for two.
19-8. timeout call. We'll be back on the other side of this commercial break. The Tigers in front, and they're doing it comfortably. Welcome back to the Clipsal Powerhouse, 19-8. Wollunga in front over West. And this is the grand final of the State League. There's been plenty of action so far, Darryl.
Yeah, handy lead so far to Wollunga. They've dominated the first quarter, but West Adelaide just haven't got on the shooting streak. 4 from 17 from the field, so it's not from the lack of trying. Just haven't got into their shooting groove, I suppose. But they've got some good shots. They've just got to knock them down and get back into this game. Early days yet. McKinnon looking to penetrate and leave. Good hands from him. Van Hoss Pelikan looking to take on Raskacek. Good move. Not quite successful there as Raskacek is dominating the defensive boards. Interesting to see defense here from West. Here Hopkins, Simpson to Lever. 10-second buzzer. See what they can come up with.
Whoops, a daisy.
Cunningham with just a deflection there. Shot clock on 8 seconds, so I'd imagine this will get into Lever's hands and he'll penetrate. And that's exactly what happens. Good dish. And 30-second shot expires. Put that down to Willie Simmons, and he intimidated Travis Lever from shooting that first shot. And that's just his presence in the keyway that's so important to West. There's virtually two players in the key.
McKinnon. 28, Wollunga in front. Cunningham.
And Harris just reaching over and getting the arm of Willie Simmons. And Willie just wants to walk you down to the block and back in and take position where he wants to take it. And it's important that Simon Harris just holds his space. And just lets Willie play 2 or 3 feet further out than what he wants to. For Simmons with a limited range, but if he gets into his jump hook area, that's good night nurse.
A minute and a half remaining. Cunningham now for West Adelaide. Oh, that was a good pass, and they needed something out of that. As Bradley McKinnon shoots unsuccessfully, though. Gee, Harris under enormous pressure. But they get it away here, Wollunga. And they've got a big chance to score here. And they do, and that is through Hopkins.
4-on-2 break there. It had to be a score. And terrific ball there and perseverance from Simon Harris defensively. And once the leader got the ball, he was away on the 4-on-2 break. West looking for the back door. McKinnon going to work on Travis Lever. Little fading jump shot. Gets the lucky roll. And it's a needed basket there from West. It's 22-10 in the last minute of this first quarter. Lever with a pull-up three. That's
ambitious.
It is for Travis. He doesn't normally shoot too many threes. But McKinnon comes up with the loose ball. And I'll say West will just run the clock down here and try and get the last shot. Wollunga will get a shot attempt. There's about a 10-second differential. Matt Hughes driving, dishes off Adam Cunningham. It's a long way out. That's the three-pointer I was talking about. Playing with heaps of confidence.
22-13. So there's 9 the difference. And Wollunga in front as we approach quarter time in this State League basketball grand final in the men's division. Simpson, oh, he loses it. 3 seconds to go. Here's Bradley McKinnon, and he scores. Valuable points right on the quarter time buzzer. 22-15, Wollunga in front. But it was a great little 15-second passage by West Adelaide. 22-15, we'll be back after this break. Welcome back to the Clipsal Powerhouse. This is the grand final in State League basketball between the Wollunga City Tigers and the West Adelaide Bearcats. And Wollunga, right at this moment, doing pretty well indeed. It's 22-15, but West Adelaide edging closer in the latter stages of the first quarter. Second quarter action now. Cunningham goes out a little wider to Hughes, McKinnon, Cunningham, Simmons. Who's a factor? There is no doubt about that. West Adelaide come away with it. Or Wollunga, I should say. Sorry, Darryl.
That's Simon Harris. Just pushing Willie Simmons just a little bit further out than what he wants to be. And he came up with a pretty ordinary attempt there at a jump shot. So that's what they need to do. Once Willie gets into the paint, Wollunga are in trouble. They don't have the athleticism to counter that. Darren Carroll sends his man away. Raskacek, 15-16 footer. nothing but net. And important that he's been pretty quiet offensively, that he gets involved. West finished that first quarter off very, very well and can take that sort of positive into the second quarter. And important for Nalunga just to steady the ship. Willie Simmons again, the focal point. And Hulse Pelican, great dish to Willie Simmons. And Harris just gets him on the arm. Smart foul because it was going to be a dunk or a guaranteed 2 points. So Simon Harris with the foul, he's second. He's going to get fouls guarding Willie, but he's just in there to do his job. He's resting the veteran, Rick Hodges. Brad McKinnon, pull up three, just not guarded at all. Bread and butter. And back to a 6 point ball game. McKinnon's been a very heavy scorer for West this season in the games that he has played. Calling a special play. Carroll to Lever, jump shot. No good. Simpson gets the scraps. And it's a West ball.
24-18, six the difference. Nalunga in front, McKinnon. Van Hulse Pelican. Chance now for Hughes, out to Cunningham. This is 4-2. Van Hulse Pelican still going. Well, he had to get that one, didn't he, Willie Simmons? You can see that.
Well, I think you'll class this as fairly high percentage. Stop that. Yeah. And that is the area that he likes to work in. David Spears pretty happy with that.
Rick Hodges coming on, by the way, Piercy for Nalunga, the 43-year-old veteran. On he comes, and Harris goes off.
He's done a pretty good job, even though Willie just dunked on his head then and got him in the photo. It did his job and just made it difficult for Simmons on most times.
I hit the photo.
Well, no one likes being in the poster when it's a dunk.
24-20. And Nalunga lead.
Simpson driving. Can't make it. Gets his own rebound. This will have to be a high loft. And Simmons, too tall on the post, comes up with a defensive rebound. You'll notice West are looking to run at every opportunity. McKinnon screaming for it on the weak side. Travis Levy just losing sight of him there for a while. And Brad McKinnon settling the ship down and obviously running a special play here. Simmons just anchors himself in the low post. And Van Hulse Pelican putting a bit of fade into that shot. Not quite his traditional shot. Simpson. And you'll find that Adam Cunningham there gets the hand check. Ricky Simpson looking to crossover change direction. Here's the crossover step. And blue passed. That's the Linda Ronstadt. Blue by you. And Adam Cunningham just throwing out the hand. And it's only the first team foul for both teams. So no one in foul trouble in this game so far. Screen and roll play for Travis Lever. And there's Simpson again. Willie Simmons again, changing everyone's shot. Travis Lever not wanting to take it completely to the rack. After all that, Adam Cunningham fouled there on the shooter, and Simpson goes the line.
24-20. The tempo's not quite there as it was in the first quarter.
Both teams have gone to their bench a little bit, and with that sometimes you lose a little bit of intensity and some combinations. So both teams, it would seem, just feeling each other out at the moment, looking for weaknesses.
Bradley McKinnon. Van Hulse Pelican still with McKinnon. Cunningham providing some protection for him.
And that was close, but Ricky Simpson with the block. McKinnon looking to penetrate. Simpson trying to get across to take the charge just a little bit late. And he gets the blocking foul.
State League basketball healthy.
It's a terrific competition. They went home and away this year to try and get some supporter-based participation from people in the club, and with the women's playing first and the men playing second on every night, and it was a good idea.
Here's Van Hulse Pelican looking for a couple. Simmons should get this. It does. Four for him. Willie Simmons up to 8 points. McKinnon with nine, and for Nalunga Simpson seven, and Carroll seven.
Nalunga haven't scored too many. It's Willie Simmons. Blocks Razicek's stuff. And McKinnon all the way. that down as, that won't be an assist to Willie Simmons, but he set up that fast break. And important that Eric Razicek still goes at Willie Simmons as he shoots the fadeaway. He says, I'd rather do it that way.
Bit of height there.
He's 6'8", and he's had a terrific season for them. So as tall as Willie Simmons is, you've still got to go at Willie. He's only got 6 fouls to spare. As the turnaround jump shot comes up short for Brad McKinnon and Malunga, who have done a pretty good job on the board so far.
Yes, Lever has it. 7 minutes and 48 seconds remaining until half-time, 28-24. Carroll. Oh, chance here for McKinnon. For West Adelaide, and down goes a West Adelaide player. He was the target. He was the target. It was Matt Hughes. He's up and okay. 28-24. Just starting to get a little rough. Not sure whether there was anything.
No, just an accidental trip as the ball was lobbed. Two players running into each other, and David Spear off the bench claiming that it was a foul. But pretty hard to call that, I suppose. But most coaches don't like most calls that go against them. We're all human. So this is back to a close ball game now, 28-24. And Nolunga have been outscored 9-6 so far in the second quarter. Hodges just out of his range. Simpson up fake, looking to penetrate. Razicek wants it. And again, well, lucky roll. Willie Simmons put that shot off. And at the end of the day, it fell out the bottom of the net. So it's 2 points. Lucky for Ricky Simpson. But again, Willie Simmons is the factor. He doesn't have to block shots to be effective. Matt Hughes, backdoor cut. And good eye contact between McKinnon and Hughes. A la Andrew Gaze, Leonard Copeland there on the back door.
For the difference, just under 7 minutes remaining. We've got a timeout here at the Clipsville Powerhouse. This is the grand final between Nolunga and West Adelaide. And at the moment, Nolunga lead by 4. We'll see you soon. Good crowd in for this State League Basketball Grand Final. 30-26, the Tigers in front. Nolunga City Tigers up against the West Adelaide Bearcats. This is the grand final. Plenty of action in the first quarter. This is second quarter action now. Oh, there's a nice couple. Nice couple there from Razicek for Nolunga. 32-26. Hughes from a fair way out. Nothing doing there for Matt. And Nolunga bring it away.
Yeah, Hughes just a little bit cold from the outside, but one from four, but he's been in great form. It's only a matter of time before he clicks. And Nolunga dominating the first quarter. West have pulled themselves back into this game. And like most teams, teams can group points together very quickly as Razicek hits two in a row. And he starts to get the feel for it. And that's bad sign for West. Cunningham thinks twice about shooting McKinnon. And there again, Simmons demanding it in the low post. Turnaround jump shot. Very good. And the veteran, Rick Hodges, comes up with a board. Travis Lever decides against penetrating. He says, let's get a good one. Razicek's a bit of a focal point there with Hodgkoop not really respecting his range. He wasn't successful on that one, but an easy open shot. And McKinnon, who has the job of running his team. Now Willie Simmons just spins and makes himself a target. Matt Hughes able to drive at every opportunity. Good move, just can't finish it off. And he's just probably letting that get to him a little bit at the moment. He's taken some decent shots that just haven't dropped for him.
34-26. Travis Lever. Now Carroll. Still with Carroll. And up he goes for two. Tries to bank it in. He gets another go at it. And he draws the foul.
I'd love to see this in replay. Darren Carroll missed his first shot. Misses his first... Now look at this. He rebounds the ball. And you know he wants to instigate some contact. He wants to get Cunningham up, 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 up. Well, yeah, that is a foul. Once a defender breaks the vertical with his arms, a clever offensive player will just throw his arms into the defense's arms and instigate contact and walk to the line. I thought it might have been a bit of an ordinary call, but in replay, Carolyn Gillespie, you're on the spot.
A Darren Carroll nails the first, 35-26, as half-time approaches. Noorlunga still with this break. Grand final of the State League basketball. Gets the second too, 36-26 and 10 the margin.
West Adelaide just losing their way a little bit, and the lead's out to 10. And Randall Lindsay there. Calls for a holding foul. He's a rather aggressive player and comes here in and does a little bit of a rough up job most games. And he's doing a bit of a job on Marcel Hodgkin, who has a short fuse, to be honest, but can play. And it's on.
Oh, yes, it is.
It's on for young and old. It's only a matter of time, Mark. As McKinnon banks a soft loft there for two, gets it back to an 8-point game. It's only a matter of time before someone ends up on the floor.
The difference, 36-28, Noorlunga City Tigers in front in this grand final. Good crowd into it, the Clipsal Powerhouse. Plenty of support for State League in South Australia. This is Lever. Out he goes to Hodges, the oldest man in the competition. This is Lever again. Not this time for him, though. Paul Bell comes away with it, gives it to McKinnon, who brings it down. This is for three, and Bradley misses that one. Up goes Bell and also Simmons. Contact called, though.
Paul Burrell just coming over the back there and getting the offensive, or should I say the rebounding foul. And it's a loose ball, so it's a team foul, and Noorlunga walked to the line with Western the bonus situation. Paul Burrell's an interesting player. He's probably only 6'3 or 4, but plays a lot bigger and loves to play in the low post, loves to get contact when he can feel his defender wrestling him. He's got some terrific spin moves, limited range, but he does a good job for West. A reasonable defender, but they're just lacking a little bit of height on the rebound and fouling to try and get possession. As Rick Hodges, a wily veteran. There aren't many sportsmen around, Mark, that are still playing at 43 years of age.
No, absolutely.
Have represented their country in any particular sport after having polio as a child. And gee whiz, he's just an ornament to the game. He's in probably better shape than he ever has been. And still has a passion for the game and loves it. So. In fact, his son normally plays in this team with him.
It's a great story, isn't it?
It's you wouldn't find that happening very often at this level.
No, absolutely not. Simmons, nice little piece of work there by Willie.
No secret to that, Mark. It's turn left, jump hook, and you can't block it. You've got to try and change him up, push him out of his range, and perhaps get him trying to shoot that right-hand hook shot, which he's not going to do. But that's just copybook style as Travis Lever throws it to the referee. Carolyn didn't oblige and catch it. I think he saw the black trousers of the referee and thought it was a singlet. We certainly realised she was a referee. Mm. Hodgkin looking to score. Up fake and the soft banker, which wasn't too soft. And West come up with the ball again. Important for both teams to pick up those sort of defensive rebounds there, Mark. And I'll give the ball straight back to the team that's taken an ordinary shot. McKinnon on the fadeaway. And Rick Hodges just losing the handle on that ball and eventually accidentally kicking it out of court. David Spear running the team now for West Adelaide. It's difficult coaching and playing at any level, and this is a good competition, good level of competition. It's hard for Spear, I'm sure, to do that, but he does well. And the deflection goes to Willie Simmons. Lucky opportunist basket, but again, had to be boring, but left-hand jump hook. And
37-32. This is Simpson. Someone's got a bell.
And it's not Paul Bell, it's a cowbell.
It's becoming quite annoying, let me tell you. Anyway, this is Carroll in the paint. Loses it. Chance now. Short, though, went to the shot from Razgacek. For the Noorlunga City Tigers, 37-32, 2 minutes and 12 seconds to go. Until the long break, half-time here in the State League Basketball Grand Final. As David Spear, the coach of West Adelaide, brings it down.
And that's a foot violation, just ball deflecting. Well, kick by the defender there, and the shot is reset. Shot clock
looking for Hodgkin. So just over 2 minutes remaining until half-time. Bell, McKinnon, Still McKinnon. He falls over and they get two, do they? Yes, they do.
Well, a foul call there. Basket counts. And McKinnon takes the ball. Now watch 31, Marcel Heitschkoop there. Set a pick. Now watch him. Great pass from McKinnon. Good heads up. Heitschkoop shoots. And Travis Lever, in a thespian way, makes it look really good. So the ball's been released. And the score counts, but because he'd already shot the ball, it's then a loose ball foul. West in the bonus, so Lever shoots for two. Now, sometimes I think that Travis Lever's gone to the woodwork shop and had his heels sanded down. He tends to fall over a lot. But he's a dogged defender, and he knows the way the referees umpire.
39-34. Now we're under 2 minutes to go until half-time. McKinnon. West Adelaide with a chance to score here late. Gee, crashing to onto the court was Simpson, yes.
Have a look at this. This is a pretty good call. I don't think Ricky had, well, you can't quite see, but I don't think he'd established position there. And Paul Bell going across the keyway. Pretty hard for Rick to pick up the charge. He's only half a step out, but pretty decent call. And he's called for the block. Paul Bell showing pretty good speed on the dribble there. Goes to the line for his two shots. And a bit of sweat on the court there being wiped up. The player's looking at Carolyn Gillespie saying, you do it. She said, that's not what I'm paid for, which is fair enough. It's actually the manager's job. And then Dan Van Hulst-Pelican obliges.
Paul Bell misses the first. Straight junior. Deceptive hard worker. 39-35, now a minute and 43 remaining. A timeout has been called here at the Clipsal Powerhouse. This is the State League Basketball Grand Final between Noarlunga City Tigers and the West Adelaide Bearcats. And at the moment, Darryl, it's 39-35, Noarlunga in front.
Yeah, well, Noarlunga going to the first quarter break with a seven-point lead, and that could have been more, but West finished that first quarter off very well. They fought back, and 4 points, of course, is nothing in a ball game in the 90s these days. And it's a pretty even contest. Noarlunga found it very easy to score early in the game, but West have upped the defensive pressure. They made it more difficult for Noarlunga, and they found it hard to score at times. Raskicek came into the game pretty well and started to get the hot hand. He's been quiet since. And no real outstanding one-out player so far in this game. As you see, Mick Osborne there, just selling his troops. And I'd imagine he'd just be wanting his team to finish off very well defensively. And get some good quality shots with 41 seconds to go in this first half. I imagine both coaches would be pretty happy. It's an even game, and West have pulled their way back into it. So
West Adelaide back out on court. Four the difference, a minute 41. 39-35, a minute 40 remaining until half-time. And Noarlunga in front. Darren Carroll. Raskicek's number 6, number 15 is Lever. This is Simpson, still with Simpson, now out to Carroll. Simpson. Still with Simpson. Nothing doing as a result of all of that. And it's still 39-35.
Yeah, good D from West Adelaide there, and the shot clock winding down. Simpson forcing the shot up with no good result there from Noarlunga. And into the last minute of this first half. Willie Simmons, 10 feet out, looking for the pass. Heitschkoop pulls up for the jump shot and nails it. That's his second one from outside. Not afraid to shoot it tonight. Missed two from that spot. That's 6 points. Important that Noarlunga finish this half well and don't throw the ball away. Noarlunga forced down to the 10-second buzzer. Two offenses in a row here as Lever will have to make something happen. Simpson got plenty of time to get a good shot off. As Heitschkoop comes up with a steal. And West with the last 20 seconds for a chance to level the score and perhaps even go 1 point ahead. You'd assume that McKinnon, they'll flatten out for McKinnon to go to work on Lever. And look for Willie Simmons here on the dish. Razgacek, big block. Simmons, last shot of the first half. Oh, big play. Paul Bell gets a tip in. It's good. And 39 all at the half.
Well, you're not going to get much closer than that. That's a pretty special first half of the State League Basketball Grand Final between Noarlunga and West Adelaide. 39 apiece. We'll catch you after the break. Welcome back to the Clipsal Powerhouse. Some very important match stats. Piercy.
39 all at the half. Pretty low scoring, but finals are normally lower scoring than normal regular season games. Shooting percentages pretty typical. 43 and 38%, pretty close. Free throws. West Adelaide only getting to the line four times in that first half, which is low, given that Willie Simmons has that presence. Three-point shooting, not too many taken so far. Rebounds pretty average, and the other stats are pretty even. So 39 all, a little bit low scoring, but that's a defensive pressure mark.
Top scorers now for the Tigers. 10 to Razgacek, and for the Bearcats, so Bradley McKinnon with 13. Willie Simmons there as well with 12. All set to go now. Second half action. State League Basketball Grand Final between Noarlunga and West Adelaide. And we are away again. Simmons gets his hand to it, but the foul has been called. And look at Willie.
No, I think what they're doing is...
I thought the foul had been called. Willie, what's Willie saying?
Well, quite often the players will try and get the ball on the way up, and we've got to toss this up again. It's very hard for a referee to throw the ball at the right height when, you know, both players are jumping early. You've got to let the ball reach its peak.
And when both players are about 7 foot nothing.
West Adelaide into offense the first time here in the second half. 39 apiece. McKinnon just scoots around Travis Lever. And West take the lead now for the first time in the game. And the first play after halftime, always pretty important. West finished that first half very well. And as they did in the first half, they've opened into a zone. And as I said before, no longer probably just lacking more than one three-point shooter. Willie Simmons is their only legitimate. Travis Lever will look to drive. He's not a three-point shooter. Razgacek's deadly from there. Can't come up with it. And Simmons just sweeps the boards clean like a vacuum.
Hughes brings it down. 39-41. West Adelaide in front. McKinnon, this is for three. He's a long way out. Not as he would have liked. Simpson gets it away quickly. Carroll. Oh, nicely... knocked away there from the hands of Razgacek.
Paul Bell just anticipating that bounce pass and getting a hand to it, and Razgacek didn't end up on the end of that pass, but good defense from him. West have sat in his zone most of the season. I know playing against Forestville, they sat in his zone a lot. Unfortunately, they weren't in his zone when I was out there. I would have loved it. But good defense from Hodgkoop, just standing his ground. Rick Hodges protesting, saying, hey, that's on the arms, but... good defense, just holding his ground and standing straight up. And there's a situation where the offense likes to jump into the defense and instigate the contact and suck the referee in. Along with the ball, though, 10-second buzzer. Razgacek finds Hodges under the hoop. Can't make it. Gets his own board. Good up fake. And West with intimidation clean up the boards.
McKinnon to Hughes. Back to McKinnon. 39-41, West Adelaide in front now. First time in the game. Simmons, Cook, a beauty.
Well, quite clearly, Mark, that's going to be Willie Simmons' 90% shot, and no longer simply have to change that. They have to defend him a different way, and even though in that case you'd be turning him into the middle of the key, which is probably against most principles, you've got to make him go to his right-hand side. Otherwise, he'll just rack up 40 points and the black team loses.
Here's Simpson. Too far. Bell, McKinnon. And down come West Adelaide again. 43-39. They've got a handy break. This is Bell. Hughes.
And Razgacek just in with a forearm. Just encroaching on the dribble cylinder, as they say these days, and gets the hand check foul. Just lacking a little bit of foot speed there defensively and trying to hold up the dribbler with a forearm. New shot clock. Matt Hughes has been pretty quiet offensively, and he's been a real rivet for them so far this season. Hodgkoop just hesitating on his shot there, and once you do that, you're not really focused on what you're doing, and couldn't make it. I think the secret here from the Lunga, they've got to penetrate. And you can't just sit on the outside and pass it. Lever, Razicek. Carroll looking to drive, good pass. And that's a good move from Razicek. Just hung up and double pumped. A bit of hang time. Good dish from Carroll. Here's Razicek. Now he takes it to them. And contact from both players. Important that big players like that are not intimidated by the might of Willie Simmons in there. Willie will sit back on his haunches and want to swat everything.
Eric Razicek from Nebraska. First year. And the big man gets the second. 43-41, 9 minutes until three-quarter time in the State League Basketball Grand Final between Noarlunga City Tigers and the West Adelaide Bearcats. West Adelaide in the red and black. Well, there's a good piece of work. Nice movement there from Marcel Hiskup. 45-41.
And Noarlunga just looking a little bit shell-shocked at the moment. And importantly, just stick to their game plan. There's a foul there. And as I said before, a good play from Darren Carroll because he penetrated. He has a quick change of direction there. And Hughes with a foul there, I think. And just too much foot speed for his defender. Drew the foul. And a clever player, Darren Carroll. Knows how to make sure he makes contact with the defender. And he's pretty reasonable from the foul line. Tends to shoot a lot of foul shots for a player that's only small. And 6 from 7 so far in this game. Make that 7 from 8. And for someone that's probably only 6'1", he plays pretty tall.
Bradley McKinnon. 45-43. Final's been terrific so far. And Bradley makes no mistake there, 47-43. West Adelaide extend their lead. 4 is the margin. Lever inside. Razicek up for 2. West Adelaide come away with it. McKinnon, all the way goes Bradley.
And Darren Carroll just helping out there and threw the arm in. McKinnon looking to take it upon himself to score most times. And he's up the tempo offensively.
Where do you see his future long term, Darryl?
Well, he's exciting. You know, there's no question that he can play in the NBL, and every year that he plays, I'm sure he's going to get a lot better. He's fairly feisty. He likes to have a go, and he's pretty focused. And I think that, you know, he's coming off the bench at the moment for Adelaide. He won't want to do that for too much longer. So that might change his career move. All depends in the future what configuration the team comes up with. You know, he's probably 6'4". He's not exactly, not even that. He's not all that tall, but good court sense, a dogged defender, and I think he's a player of the future that you know, you can build a team around.
So Noarlunga desperate to score, 49-43, and West Adelaide in front at this very moment. Here's Carroll now from a long way out. Or Bradley McKinnon up high. Jump tall then, 49-43. Here's a couple. There's a couple for Hitchcock. Marcel Hitchcock.
I think he might find a timeout pretty soon here. Yeah, that was always on the cards. I think Mike Osborne just looking to steady the ship a bit as West Adelaide get excited.
51-43. We'll be back on the other side of this break. But the Bearcats lead over the Tigers here at the Powerhouse. Welcome back to the Clipsal Powerhouse, and West Adelaide Bearcats, Darryl, have turned this right around.
They have. Early in the first quarter, 4 from 17 from the field, they were struggling. They've got that up to 43%. As Darren Carroll shuffles his foot, that's a travel, and that's just what the doctor did not order. And the timeout from Mick Osborne, just to steady the boys down. They need to themselves call it more back into this game. They're now 8 down, and haven't scored too many points in this second half. McKinnon's looked to score a lot. He's on fire. Simmons gets it out to Matt Hughes, to McKinnon. Pick and roll. Hodgkoop sets the pick for him. Fade away. Just out of his range. Hodgkoop blocked by Razicek. Comes up with the ball. What a heavy body work in there. Razicek and Hodgkoop.
looking all right, aren't they, at the moment? Composed.
They are. It's just whoever's going to keep their composure, you're exactly right. And it's only a matter of time before someone throws one, I think. Oh, Matthews down on one knee.
I hope not. All in brawl last time that happened. Oh, what about that by Bradley McKinnon on the other side, though? And he wasn't looking for that. But it was pretty quick work. Just baseline drive attempt, but
just lost the handle on it.
Yeah, unsuccessful. 51-43.
I think Raskacek could be the answer here for Nalunga. Just around the foul line area. Hodges on the baseline. Shoots the 10-footer and it goes 14. Wouldn't be happy with that. McKinnon on the pull-up short. And Nalunga come up with the scraps. Pretty up and down basketball at the moment. Pretty up-tempo sort of game. And West now still sitting in the zone. Raskacek's got to make himself available around the foul line area. Carroll looking to penetrate. Lever to Darren Carroll. Fakes. Pull-up jumper. And it's good. Important bucket for the Nalunga Tigers.
Yeah, six for difference now. 5 minutes and 50 seconds remaining. Three-quarter time is approaching. Bradley McKinnon screaming some instructions. Bell. Willie Simmons, top of the key. Chance now for Hitch. Kirby gets it. There's a couple. Number 31, Marcel Hitchcoop, or Hitchcoop. 45-53, and West Adelaide still with this very handy break.
Yep, they have, and no longer haven't worked out the secret to the zone. Simpson from three-point territory. Well, short-term, that's the answer. Big bucket.
He's pumped up about it, too.
Well, he was the leader in the first quarter. He set up a very good blitz in the first quarter. I think they were 19-8 up. And Ricky Simpson set the tempo. He's been around a long time, and they'll rely on him to show some composure and some leadership. And no longer just have to up their defensive pressure, I think, here. Screen and roll play from McKinnon. David Spear back into the game for his first touch in the second half. And that's the man that's doing some damage. Again, you allow the man to drive middle, and you've got some real problems. And no longer, Raskacek caught out of position there, and Hodgkin just driving hard and collecting the foul, and drawing the foul, I should say, and he goes to the line.
53-48. Hodgkin misses the first.
And that's the beauty of driving middle and causing some problems, and defensively no longer need to keep them and need to force West Adelaide down the sidelines and away from the paint.
Six in it, 4 minutes and 50 seconds until three-quarter time. McKinnon, quick as a flash for the Bearcats, down into offense. Under 5 minutes remaining now until the last break. Simmons, nothing doing with that hook shot. Gets it back again. Hodgkoop. Willie Simmons, still with Simmons, not this time again, Hodgkoop. A third time lucky perhaps, yes, no, it won't be registered.
Well, Marcel Hodgkoop called for the push there. Let's have a look at it. Simpson's got position and just digs the shoulder in there and charges into Ricky Simpson. And there's no basket there. So it's a 6-point ball game with 4:20 to go here in this third quarter.
You've seen a few finals, Darryl, in this competition. How does this rate so far?
Well, it's pretty neck and neck. I think if no longer can avoid turning the ball over, they're a chance. As West Adelaide protesting there with an out-of-bounds call. But it's no longer ball. You notice normally finals are lower scoring because the stakes are higher, the defensive pressure is up. And you know, when you've got the two best teams playing off in the grand final, you would expect it to be close. Simpson driving, looking to draw the foul and throw up a tough one. Good hands from Ricky Simpson and came up with the scraps. Good job. And McKinnon gets the hands foul. I've got to pay credit to the hustle there of Simpson. Tried to force up the shot and draw the foul. Came up short, stole the ball, lost it, stole it again. And ended up getting fouled as Brad McKinnon got an arm in there to register his second foul.
You actually get quite sore after playing a game like this, so with this intensity, a lot of bodies going onto the ground and
Yeah, well, generally the bigger players would feel sore. They're banging in the low post. And, you know, trying to defend Willie Simmons wouldn't be easy. As Rick Hodges just throws a little up fake and gets the quick release off against Willie Simmons.
I'm sore just watching him.
Yeah, sometimes there'll be a few bone-jarring screens set, I think, as Willie Simmons looks to get the ball in the post against Hodges. If he shoots it, it'll be a left-hand jump hook. How about that? No secret to that. Simmons has only scored on a jump hook and a dunk. I mean, that's his game, and without being repetitive, they've no longer have to change the defensive strategy. And Hodges lost the handle and came up with a basket. There's a West Adelaide hand in there, but Hodges showing great agility. And he gets it back with a four-point game.
There's 56-52, under 3 minutes to go. Simmons, who's causing some sort of chaos down that end of the court, and up the other end of the court for that matter. 2 minutes and 50 remaining until three-quarter time. Lever now to take it.
Just saw in that situation, they forced Willie Simmons to his right-hand side, had to shoot a fadeaway jump shot, came up short. So he's not being allowed to do what he wants to do. So if you let him shoot that jump shot, I mean, you're just not going to stop him. And no longer with the fumbles there.
Interesting trick there by Razkacek. Oh, nice work. Well done by Darren Carroll.
Well, that was a prayer, Mark, but it was answered. It was just a low percentage fadeaway. He finished up on his backside, but tough shot from him.
Two in it now. So they have lifted the tempo somewhat, Norlunga.
And Willie Simmons called for a rebounding foul. McKinnon shot the three-pointer, and Norlunga had good body position, blocking him out, and Willie was forced to just get into the back of his defender. And just got in, good call for an offensive push. And all of a sudden, a little bit of a change in the complexion of the game.
It's ebbed and flowed a bit, hasn't it?
Well, it has. In this last 2 minutes, it's quite often games are won and lost with just the finishing of the quarter. Now, all of a sudden, Western in the bonus, so that being a loose ball foul puts Razkacek on the line. He's very reliable from the foul line most times. And he had the opportunity to level the scores, only two the difference now.
Gee. That's interesting. Ben Holst Pelican on now for West Adelaide. He's an athletic type. 56-54. There's two the margin. West Adelaide lead.
Well, Wayne Maidman's called that from Crittenden Road. And it's right in front of Carolyn Gillespie, who didn't call it. So brave call, but there's a judge that Rick Hodges is into the back of Willie Simmons. So that's one apiece in the last two plays.
Bell, top of the key. Still with Bell. Trying to do it all himself. Doesn't to come up all that well. Spear, in fact, it was. I'm getting the colours mixed up. My apologies.
All these West Adelaide players look the same, Mark.
Thank you, Darryl.
They're no longer looking for the shot here, and they need a good quality shot. West just have sat in this zone the whole quarter. It's been pretty successful. Hodges finds Razkacek. That's the weak spot of that zone. And that's his range. That's he knocked two or three down in a row in the first half. And if you have to go out and close out the wings, that foul line can be left naked. And he's deadly from there. Van Hoss Pelican drives in. Big play, Simpson. Read the play well, took the charge. Hand off to Van Hoss Pelican. Took it strong with the hoop. And Simpson saw it coming. Good defensive position. Pretty obvious charge. And a big play is the game now. It's 56 all. No longer have the chance now to take the lead.
Exciting stuff here. There's Travis Lever. For Norlunga, Simpson, now Razkacek, Lever, Razkacek, turn, shoots.
Oh, Simpson, great stuff.
Yeah, Ricky Simpson, well done. Nice piece of work, Carroll. Now Lever, 57 seconds remaining until three-quarter time, 56 apiece. Norlunga and West Adelaide. This is the State League Grand Final in the men's division. He loses the handle on it, and Cunningham gleefully just takes it away. And as a result, Spear, the nice pass to Simmons, who loses the handle.
Wow. Carolyn Gillespie calling a foul on Darren Carroll from long way away. She must be eating her carrots. Great eyesight. She could be right. Let's have a look. David Spear with the lob pass. Found Willie Simmons. Darren Carroll. Ooh. You can hear the sound of leather from over here, but maybe he got a bit of arm there. And Simmons goes to the line for two. Unsuccessful on the first. Very important to finish this third quarter off for both teams. And Simmons misses both, so that's a good reply for Razgicek, who missed both of his. They're going tit for tat at the moment.
This is Carroll. There's 34 seconds remaining, 23 on the shot clock. Simpson, Lever.
You know, coaching-wise, I'd just go for two for one here. I'd look to get a good shot up early. West then would have 30 seconds, but you still get your third shot.
Okay, so here's Lever. Now a chance for Simpson. He nails it. Ricky Simpson. 10 seconds now to go until three-quarter time. It's 59-56, and Norlunga lead.
McKinnon off to Spear. He's got to get that shot off. Big play. And that won't count. So good hustle from Norlunga there at the end.
Oh, very much so, Darryl. 59-56. So Norlunga stormed to the lead with a quarter to go in the State League Basketball Grand Final. We will be back after these messages. Welcome back to the Clipsal Powerhouse. Last quarter action about to get underway in the State League Men's Basketball Finals. Norlunga City Tigers in front over the West Adelaide Bearcats. It's been an exciting final so far. Daryl Pearce has joined us right throughout the match. What do you think, Pearce?
Well, this is just a great culmination for the Bank SA League. And terrific game so far. The third quarter for Norlunga, they're doing a bit of a rags to riches. Jekyll and Hyde job as Matt Hughes, good hustle, throws the ball back behind his back and unfortunately into the backcourt. So it's a backcourt violation, obviously. Norlunga there just seem to drop their bundle and get behind, and West like they'd take the game away, or get control at least. And in the last 3 minutes, Norlunga just turned it around, went into the three-quarter break with a three-point lead, and that's the score now at 59-56. Norlunga now hoping to take that end of that third quarter into this fourth quarter. And milk it down to get a good lead. Razgicek, he's been pretty impressive in the third quarter here. Lever penetrates to Carroll. Carroll for the three-pointer. All draws. Six-point lead to Norlunga City.
Gee, they've turned this right around, haven't they? Here's Bradley McKinnon now. Out he goes to Hughes. Back to McKinnon. Now Hughes in the paint. That was for two. Now he decided to dish off. And he gave it to Bradley McKinnon, who didn't let him down. It's 62-58. There's Paul the difference.
Travis Lever now for Norlunga. Razgicek looking to set the pick at the top of the key. Eric Razgicek has got to make himself available at the top of the key there to draw Willie Simmons, who normally just sits under the ring and looks to rebound. Hodges cross-court to Darren Carroll, who's been impressive tonight. Pull-up jumper short. And, oh, Ricky Simpson almost with a tip-in. Not quite. And Willie Simmons cleans up.
Important play here now is Matt Hughes and Hodgkirk. McKinnon. Hodgkirk.
You probably find Simmons becoming a real factor here in this fourth quarter as McKinnon's three-point attempt rims out. Simmons has got to score heavily in the fourth quarter for West to win, I think, and you'll find that he'll be looking to get into position in the block there and go to work on Rick Hodges. Hodges will need some support as Darren Carroll's been on fire. Pull-up jumper, and he's been impressive so far. If he can keep his head, he could be a real important cog for them also.
Out to six now. And Norlunga in front. Hughes misses. Hodgkirk, yes!
See, tough play, Marcel Hodgkirk. There was defended very well and double pumped, bit of hang time, and changed his shot and banked it sweetly. Ricky Simpson looked to take the charge, but that was from Hollywood. Lever finds Ricky Simpson. Darren Carroll, good entry pass. And a great entry pass from Darren Carroll there. Normally should be a bounce pass, but he was on the money. Normally that's a bounce pass, probably not the greatest angle, but it found the money. Razgacek is fouled, and Willie Simmons with a block, but it's after the foul, and Razgacek goes to the line with his team up 4 points. Looking pretty impressive, Mark, Eric Razgacek.
He's been averaging 22 points per game this season, 7.4 rebounds and 3.1 blocks.
Yep, leads his team in all categories, and because he has that good 15-16 point range, and that's the zone, he can just virtually sit on the foul line and just ding away, and Willie Simmons has to come out and defend him, which probably draws him away from good rebounding position. So good inside-outside player, Razgacek.
Simmons, Hodgkirk. Now Simmons again from McKinnon. Oh, what about that?
Just surprise, surprise, Mark. Yeah. A jump hook on the left hand.
How unusual.
Well, it's an NBA move. I mean, you can't block that when the guy's 6'11 and shoots from that height. And again, I hate being boring, but you just got to change your shot. Rick Hodges there, intimidated slightly. Couldn't make the basket. And so Matt Hughes puts the Jets on Darren Carroll. McKinnon to Hodgkirk. And as we predicted, Willie Simmons becoming a factor there in the low post.
Just an exciting final. Crash, bang. Here's McKinnon, gets it out to Hodgkirk, and Hodgkirk. Oh, what about that? Well, you don't see that too often.
That's a very lucky shot, but it's in the book. And West draws to within 1 point of Nalunga. Travis Lever says, let's settle it down and get a good one.
65-64.
Finds Ricky Simpson. Darren Carroll on the drive. And just a little bit of trash talking. Let's have a look at this. Darren Carroll on the drive. And Brad McKinnon clearly there. And Carroll gets his fourth foul. And Brad tells him all about it. A little bit of trash talking there. As you said before, no love lost between these two teams. And those two boys are fairly aggressive in their approach to the game. So, get a feeling out there. And with 8:16 to go in this Bank SA final, it's anyone's game. Just a bit of sweat on the court there. As the game just gets stopped, as Nalunga have upped their defense now, double-teaming Brad McKinnon in the backcourt. He breaks the shackles pretty easily. Been a pretty topsy-turvy game. You'd think that Nalunga got a bit excited there and busted out the 6 points and looked impressive. West have fought back. And just need to show a little bit of composure. Simmons again in the low post. And a left-hand jump hook. So Willie Simmons becoming the factor now. He's got 20, 48%, 10 of 21 shot attempts so far. Fortunately, no longer they don't get sucked into the vigour shown here on defence. As Ricky Simpson says, I'll lead you to victory, boys. He knocks down the two-pointer. And 68-66.
Bell. Still Bell. Ooh, almost. 68-66. Nalunga in front by two. 7 minutes and 17 seconds remaining. Lever brings it down now for Nalunga. Simpson. Out it goes. Razgacek. Simmons.
Well, Razgacek did the right thing. They went right at Willie Simmons and looked to slam the ball. Let's have a look at this in replay. Right down the middle of this zone. Went hard. Simmons definitely got the ball and some body. And Razgacek hit the turf pretty hard. But that's a real positive statement. You've got to go at a player like Willie Simmons, who's had a fantastic season and is the focal point of the West Adelaide offense. But any player's only got six fouls to spare. And Willie is one of the greatest shot blockers around, I should say. But he had to foul and picked up his third foul.
Two in it. Nalunga in front.
And Razgacek's 3 from 6 so far. Normally a fairly good foul shooter. And he's back on track.
Right on the money there. Three in it. 69-66. 7 minutes and 7 seconds remaining until full time.
And Eric Razgacek says, take that. So two in a row to him. 70-66. And Nalunga back in front by four. And looking to steady the ship a little bit. Matt Hughes has been a little bit quiet. He could come into the game soon. Hodgkoop taking the ball strong there with arms flying all over the place. He's a strong player, Marcel Hodgkoop. And you'll often find that he makes a statement physically in these games and says, look, I'm taking it at you. Get in my way if you will. And Ricky Simpson gets the hands foul. Hodgkoop goes to the line for two. Ex-Norwood player has been playing for West for some time now. And speaking to David Spear, he relies a lot on Hodgkoop for the body work and the vigour to keep his team aggressive.
Lever brings it down, 70-67. And Woolunga in front by just three. Simpson. Hodges. Carroll is seven. Simpson. 6.5 minutes remaining, and there's a couple for Razgacek. A couple for Razgacek. It's 72-67.
Well, he's come into the game. He's got 19 for the game so far. And he's starting to look pretty aggressive offensively. It's Matthews driving dish to Cunningham to Willie Simmons. That trademark shot just a little bit short for Simmons. But Big Willie's getting good quality shots there. Just a matter of knocking it down. And he's starting to play very well in the second half. Rick Hodges finds Travis Lever. The Woolunga like to keep the court pretty spread. Simpson looking to penetrate. Oh, great clever dish. And Hodges just losing the handle on that.
Cunningham underneath the basket. And bringing it down now is Hughes. Still with Hughes. This is for two. Not this time. Carroll gives it across to Lever. So we've got 5.5 minutes to go. It's getting very tense now. Darren Carroll out to Simpson. Now to Lever. Now to Hodges. Simpson. Still with Simpson. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Up he goes for two. Willie Simmons gets up. Just gleefully takes the rebound. And McKinnon crashes to the ground. And so too does the number 15, which is Travis Lever.
Here's McKinnon taking it strong to the hoop. Travis Lever getting that thigh in there, and that's definitely a block. Has the uncanny knack of, no matter where you hit Travis Lever, he manages to fall backwards as if he's taking a charge. He's a very clever player, but not all of his game is acting. He's a very good player and runs the team well, good penetrator, good team player. And he's gutted me a few times this season, and he's pretty hard to shake. David Spear, their coach of West Adelaide.
My apologies, David, for calling you someone else completely different.
Well, someone younger. So he'd love that. Spear's not as old as me, but he is getting old.
I called him Paul Bell, but I mean, let's forgive and forget, eh? What about that Hodgkoop? So they're back in business here. 72-69. West Adelaide getting a little closer. Three the difference.
Just into the last 5 minutes now of this pretty tight tussle here in the Bank SA final at the Clipsal Powerhouse, and Woolunga looking to hold on to this slim 3-point lead. Carroll, 10-second buzzer now going, and Simpson will look to go at Adam Cunningham. Spin move. Simpson's waiting for him. So Simpson driving hard, and Willie Simmons waiting there to intimidate. And Ricky Simpson trying to dump the ball off to Rick Hodges. Knocked away by West Adelaide. So no longer get the ball back, but with only 4 seconds to go. Lob play, Razgacek. Oh! Big play. Out of bounds play, lob. And have a look at this. Let's see if we can get it. Out of bounds play, lob. And Razgacek dunks easily. McKinnon's strong move on Lever. Travis Lever wants the charging foul. No call. And sometimes if you fall over too often, they'll just ignore you. But
I think he hurt himself too. Yes, he has.
Back to 3 points now. No longer still in control by only three. Razgacek with his tail up, looking to go on Marcel Hodgkoop. Short. Ball comes out to Ricky Simpson. And a new shot clock for Woolunga.
Lever out to Carroll. Carroll tries to penetrate, looking for a couple. Hodges was there underneath the basket, but he couldn't do anything constructive with it. Still three the difference, 74-71. And the clock stops at 3 minutes and 49 seconds. Chance now.
And Razgacek's foul by Willie Simmons after he's released it, but it'll be a shooting foul with you're still in your shooting motion until you hit the floor, until you, your ground hits the floor. So, maybe Razgacek. And that's what happens when you're on fire and you start to score. You've got to be respected. Willie normally wouldn't close out that far, but has to because of Razgacek's range. And good defense from Simmons, but he had the foul. Now, Razgacek with another miss. It's 5 for 9 from the line, and they can be costly. But he's successful with his second. Gets it out to a four-point ball game, 75-71.
So Bradley McKinnon now getting things moving immediately for West Adelaide. Hughes involved in that, and also Cunningham back to McKinnon. Simmons posting up, gets it. McKinnon, this is for three. Oh, that would have been handy. Lever's away. Now it's 2-on-2 situation. Lever has it, still has it. Cunningham comes at him, puts the pressure upon him.
Well, good hustle from Adam Cunningham, but unfortunately taking Travis Lever's legs out from under him. And...
yeah, Lever's hand is, his wrist is, forearm is quite sore too. By the way, he's just holding his left forearm at 75-71 here in the grand final. And at the moment, it is Noarlunga in front. We'll catch you after the break. Welcome back to the Clipsal Powerhouse. And Darryl, it is tense. We've got 3 minutes and 22 seconds remaining at 75-71. And at the moment, Noarlunga in front.
Yeah, four-point lead, which is important with only just over 3 minutes to go. But we're still in this ball game. Anyone's game, and important offense here. If West can get a stop, Darren Carroll looking to penetrate, comes up with an ordinary shot. His own rebound. Oh, huge play. Great hustle. Threw up a brick, got his own rebound, and double pump, made the basket. So have a look at this. Tough shot, probably lost the handle on that. Shot it like a dart. It came back to him. And just watch this double pump. Up, hang, and just got Hyde-Scoop's hip, I think. And he's fouled. Scored the basket. As you can see, look at the biceps on the man. He's a strong young lad. And I think he'd live in the weight room. And he goes to the line for the bonus. That's a six-point lead. It's a big play. Carroll very reliable from the foul line. He knocks it down. That's 8 from 9 from the foul line for him for the game. Takes him to 23 points.
78-71 now. We're in the last 3 minutes. They really need this. That is a very good and very timely shot there by Matt Hughes. 78-74. They're back in it again.
He's been tough all season, Mark, from three-point range, and he's been quiet so far tonight, but a class act. And, as Hyde-Scoop gets a handle here, this will be a foul. Oh, loses it. Oh, that's a foul.
Well, what a finish to this grand final. Let's have another look at this.
Now, Travis Lever, now, if that's not playing the ball, I'm very surprised that's an intentional foul. You know, I've seen a lot worse. Anyway, that's a big call. We're at 2:34 from the end of this game. Four-point lead, it was always going to be a foul. McKinnon goes to the line, but more importantly, West will get the ball from the sideline. And a sportsmanlike foul there. And at least Travis Lever and his boys have just left that alone and got on with the game. But, gee, it was a big call. And West can narrow this back to 2 points and possession, so theoretically on the next offense they can take the lead. And McKinnon can't put it away, but that's changed the game completely there. So two shots and possession for that intentional foul. And West now with a chance to just edge closer. They need a good quality shot. Simmons finds Cunningham and McKinnon. He's looking to take over. Three-pointer. Can't get it. Carroll got a hand to it. Simpson comes up with it and goes to Travis Lever.
So Lever now, 78-75. Noarlunga in front. The Noarlunga City Tigers. This is the grand final of the State League competition in men's basketball. Simpson taking on Cunningham. Still with Simpson. Doesn't fall for him.
And just a blood rule there. Adam Cunningham with a bleeding knee has to go out. And it'll be very interesting to see who subs in for him. Van Hulst-Pelicano, I reckon. Bit of a... David Spear coming into the game, the player coach of the Bearcats, and one of the more experienced players in this competition. Spear's had a lot of NBL games, and he is West Adelaide. His blood would bleed red and black, I think. Spear, a staunch Westies man, and a big play for him to come into the game. West three down, but they have possession. Backdoor play, big play. And that was a very costly turnover there. It's the right play, just the pass just wasn't on the money there on the back door. Darren Carroll, he's had a terrific game for Nolunga. Lever, looking, probably not the right angle to get into Raskicek. Simpson, Carroll, pick and roll play. Oh, that's out of his range. Nolunga need a better shot than that, Mark.
Hughes. A minute 13 remaining, still with Matt Hughes. Now McKinnon, left-hand hook. It goes in. Simmons, 78-77, won the difference.
No secret where that ball's probably going to go on offense. It's going to be McKinnon on the penetration or just singling out Simmons in the low post there.
What a finish this is.
Back to one into the last minute. So the clock's on the side of Nolunga, of course, and this crowd really trying to get into this game. And... Nolunga quite happy to roll this clock down to the last 10 seconds. Ricky Simpson looking to penetrate on McKinnon. Travis Lever drives, pulls up for the jumper. Rims out. West with the board now with 35 seconds to go. Have the chance to take the lead. They're down one. And West call the timeout.
I'll bet they do. So what about this? What a great finish, Darryl.
It's a terrific comeback here by West. And also, Nolunga have come up with a couple of pretty ordinary shots the last two plays. And... I think West just calling the timeout to run a play. And my last cent would be on clear out and throw it into Willie in the low post. And fair chance it's going to be a left-hand jump hook. And just West Adelaide players have to go to the board.
So the situation is there's 32 seconds left in the match. There's 24 seconds left on the shot clock. It's 78-77. Nolunga are in front. And it is very, very exciting here. There's a good crowd here, possibly a couple of thousand, perhaps even a few more, here at the Clipsal Powerhouse. Let's have a listen to what David Spears say.
Make the shot now. If we score it,
Spears trying to get across to them is they've got one shot here. They've got 32 seconds, obviously 30 seconds to get a shot off. If they can score the basket, they hit the lead. He doesn't want them to foul defensively because it's going to put Nolunga on the line. So West have got plenty of time here to get a good quality basket. If they score, they hit the lead. And then defensively, he's saying, don't foul. Just make them win the game from their own shot. So we're just trying to work out.
Lots of drama here at the moment. That is for sure. Marvellous climax to the season.
And West call a timeout straight away so they can make a sub. Now, West, of course, have 30 seconds to get a shot off. There's about a two-second differential here. Big play for West. You think if they come up short here, it'll be pretty hard-pressed to win. But if they knock this down, then the ball's in their court. Simmons in the low post, looking to operate. Sorry, I'm wrong. They've only got 8 seconds to shoot. McKinnon's got to get this off. Tough fadeaway. He makes it. 10 seconds to go, though. Simpson's got to drive. Oh, I think he might have been fouled there. And it's all over.
An unbelievable finish to the State League Grand Final. Look at the scenes here, Piercy, with the West Adelaide Bearcats getting up in the concluding stages. What a grand final.
Fantastic effort, a very close game all the way, and each team getting ahead, looking to take the game away, the other team fighting back. West looked done to a dinner there in the last minute, came back a couple of clutch baskets. McKinnon coming up with a huge play. Look at this, with the clock running down. I thought they had a full 30 seconds. He was only 8 on the shot clock. McKinnon, this is the toughest shot he'll probably hit in his career. A step back going the wrong way. Lever right in his face. Makes the basket. And, of course, the shot clock stops once the ball goes to the ring. 10 seconds to go. And Nalunga needed to get a shot. Ricky Simpson set up a pretty hard shot. It's the only one he could come up with. And Nalunga claimed he was fouled. No call. And the game's over. So West, who, even though they didn't finish top, I think were the most consistent team all season, and coming into the finals, have proved that they're worthy champions.
Fantastic finish. Let's have a look at some match stats, Darryl.
Well, let's have a look at this for a close game. 78-79, one-point game. Field percentage exactly the same. Free throws, West at only 42%, but only 14 attempts, which is low. Three-point percentage, they struggled 21% only, with Brad McKinnon 1 from 8, which probably didn't help that. And rebounding pretty even, 42-all, obviously. Most of the stats pretty even, and the scores even. So impressive play. McKinnon was tough with 26. Simmons 22 himself, and Hodgkin 20. So the three main scorers there.
Yes, there are the scorers. And what a wonderful finish to the season. And Bradley McKinnon really pretty well the hero there with that useful shot about 10 seconds to go.
Well, it's funny. I mean, he took 28 shots for the game, so he was their main contributor and main shot taker along with Simmons. So he struggled from the three-point range, but you know, he shot very well from inside, that 10 from 16 from inside. So he's obviously a player of the future and a big part of the West Adelaide thing. And West Adelaide know how to celebrate, and David Spear would be very, very happy with that win. And congratulations to him as the coach of that team. It's very hard to play and coach, and I'm sure that Speary probably played less minutes than what he'd like to make sure that the team was well coached and they got the championship.
So just repeating the scores, 79-78. The West Adelaide Bearcats are champions for 1996 in the State League Basketball Championship in the men's division. And it was a fantastic game of basketball. I hope you've enjoyed Ten's coverage of the State League men's basketball final. On behalf of my co-commentator, Darryl Pearce, and the Ten Sport crew, good night from the Clipsal Powerhouse.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it. Nice, sweet, fantastic. Move up on a bit, yes, you move it. Pony woman, you're nice, sweet, fantastic. Bridge up on a bit, move a bit, Titanic. Physically fit, physically fit, physically, 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 physically. Move on, physically.